human mind steps aside, giving way to new realms and reality alternatives. Welcome to the Alt Series.
Welcome to Alt, number two.
Yes. What did you do?
No, you did it.
Welcome
Take
back.
Take responsibility.
Welcome
for
back,
it.
Everybody. We actually kind of, we have Alt Brain. What else? Neuro Weird.
Yeah.
We forgot to introduce the audience members when we came in.
And I know why.
Why?
Because we haven't had a live audience at the studio for so long that everybody feels new.
Yeah. So
special.
So actually, we're gonna go back in time a little bit to at the beginning of the welcome session from last segment, and now introduce the people who are here, whether the new or from out of state, right? And Linda's got a list.
Is this neural weird?
This is very weird. We're going to introduce you. So, Linda, who's on the list?
Okay, so let's...
Go ahead.
Out of staters... Oh, out of country first.
Out of country, wow.
Okay. Luke Ramsey, where are you, sir?
Right.
Hello, there you are.
Sai. Sai. Good to meet you.
No, yeah. That was Luke Lesage.
Let's see, you're
Wait,
from...
I didn't screw it up. It was
no,
Luke
now
Lesage.
We're with Sai over here. You've got to be from England, I can tell just from the accent. Yeah.
Yes, British,
yes. Liverpool. Oh, wow. Good. Welcome here. The first time also, right? Yeah. And we want to use the microphone.
I have my microphone on.
No, for
oh,
them.
Are we going to run the mic for this? Okay.
I don't know.
Now, can we start? Because I actually was starting right.
Okay, go ahead.
Because top of my list to announce is Luke Lesage.
Luke Lesage.
There we go. Welcome,
Canada.
Luke.
Canada, welcome.
How are you doing?
Why do I have the microphone?
I have no
to
idea.
To say hello.
You didn't pay
look,
me.
Look in that camera. Look in that camera right there and say hello, Shambra.
I was a free and sovereign, intolerant son of a bitch.
Yes,
is
you
that
are.
What you wanted me
yes,
to say?
You are. I know. Yes. I'm so glad you shared that. Yes.
Thank you, Luke.
We all know that about him.
Bye, bye, Luke. Bye, bye. Grab that microphone, Linda. Hurry.
Now, properly, Sai from Ramsey.
I'll do it again. Hi.
Yeah. From England.
Nice to meet you all from England. Sai Ramsey. Yes.
See, now
Sai.
They can hear you online. Everyone before they were just.
Ah, great. Okay. Yeah. Yes. So, yeah. Sai from England, UK, from Liverpool.
Great. Good to have you here.
Good to meet you all.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you. And next, Florencia Duran from Mexico.
Hi, Flo.
Mexico.
Hi.
Good to see you again.
Hi. Yeah, same.
Great.
Hi.
And since we've seen you last, you now have your PhD, I believe, Dr. Flo.
Yeah.
Wow.
Woo! Yes, thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. Okay, Annette, how are you?
Hello, Shambra.
Annette, good to see you again.
Thank you. Right,
you've come a long
I'm
way
good.
From Norway.
Yes.
Yeah. Good. Are you
yes.
excited?
Yes, I am.
Great. I see you're sitting in the front row, front seat.
Risky business.
Okay. Yeah, all right.
Risky business.
Yeah.
Risky
yeah.
business.
Good.
And it's okay if I'm not getting the microphone also, so.
Oh, no. Oh, you're going to get the microphone.
Even if I'm
me.
Sitting here.
Oh, no.
You haven't
no.
paid me. Okay. Okay.
Good. Thank you.
Where's Paula? Aletta. There we go. Hi, Paula.
Hi, Paula.
Hi, Shambra. First Hi. Time here.
Wow.
Yeah, Minnesota. Other places, yeah. but first time here.
Yeah, good to see you.
Nice.
Glad
Paula
you're here.
From Minnesota.
Minnesota, yeah. How about them Vikings?
Wow. Agnes Deek from North Carolina. Where
I hate
are you,
the Vikings.
Ladies? There we go.
Hi, everyone. Good to be here.
But you're not from out of town, are you?
Not anymore.
Not anymore. Didn't you move here recently?
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
Just when it got cold.
Yeah. Congratulations. Thank you for being here. And you'll love it here. It's an amazing place.
Yeah. I feel very happy to be here.
Yeah. Good.
It's
Thank
like
you.
Home.
It is like home.
Yeah, thanks.
Yep.
Thank you. Cece from Washington. Where is Cece? There
Cece.
We go.
Hi, thank you. I'm Cece Artemisia, and I changed my name legally a year or so ago, and I guess I didn't change it on your website.
Oh.
So they gave me
that's what's in
my
our
old
database.
Name. So yeah.
And what is your last name?
Artemisia.
That's a good name. Wow.
Thank you.
Better than Hoppy.
I'm not saying anything. Thank you.
Yeah, please don't.
Okay, Tracy.
I'm going to change it to Hope, though. You know, it's really close to Hope. All right, sorry.
Hello, I'm Tracy from Nebraska.
Hi, Tracy from Nebraska.
I'm really glad to be here and meet everyone in person.
Good, good. It's kind of exciting. There's a lot of energy here. There's so much energy here that we blew a fuse over in the kitchen before. Yeah, yeah. So, and Carrie's running around, where's the fuse box? And like, Carrie, it has nothing to do with the fuse box.
Yeah, exactly.
Trust me.
Zan here, I don't think Zan made it. Zan, Ben?
No. Uh-uh.
No. Okay. Tamara Wilson, where are you? There you are.
Hey, Tamara.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
I'm from L.A.
Glad to see you.
Glad to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah. Thank you. This is very similar to L.A., right?
Are there anybody else that has snuck in that's from a different place?
We're all from different places, Linda.
You know what I mean.
All right.
Don't
torture me. Well, thank you, everybody, and thank you to everybody online that's watching in. We are so delighted to have you here today. We're going to be doing the breathing right now and then the music and into...
I'm so excited. How many... I've never seen you wear socks like that.
They're not that... I mean, they're kind of cute, but not all that cute. Thank you. They're my Christmas socks. I don't wear shoes when I'm channeling, so I got to have nice socks.
It's nice that they match.
Yes. See? Yeah. No holes. No, they're brand new. Never been abused. Okay, let's get into it. If I can shift gears here. Okay.
So are you ready for Adamus? Ah, hear that. Feel that energy. So with that, breathe in that energy that you just shared. Really feel it. That good deep breath of life. Feel it flowing throughout your body. Breathe, breathing in the energies of all the potentials here for each of us. It's there. Just choose it, breathe it in. And while we're at it, breathe and choose the safe space, because this is a safe space. Breathe and flow. Adamus is here. You can feel his energies. Breathe those in if you choose. Oh, and he has friends with him. Breathe in those energies, feel it, and flow with it. So take the good deep breath and stay with this beautiful breath of life as we go forward.
I am that I am. Adamus of Sovereign Domain. So good to be back with... real people. With a live audience. Dear Linda, I love you, but you bear the brunt. You're kind of the iconic figure for all Chambra, and I know it must be tiring during some of our shouts where I have to just pick
beat on me.
You. Just beat on you. So today, you can sit back, you can relax, you can pass the microphone to the others that are sitting here, but before we get into today's show, there's a very important thing that needs to be taken care of immediately. Coffee, Carrie. Coffee, please. Coffee, Carrie. Oh, and a treat. Thank you.
It's chocolate cheesecake.
You know, I don't come around that often. And one of the fine things is a good cup of coffee and chocolate cheesecake.
That coffee took a lot. To happen right now because somebody blew all the circuits.
Who did that, Carrie?
I don't know. I needed an extension cord.
So you had to do an extension cord? Oh, I mean, and if you think that's tough.
It's so much out of me.
If you think.
Dinner might be late.
If you think that's tough, wait till heaven's cross. Yeah.
Merry Christmas. Mm.
Your cheek is cold. No, not that one, the other one.
What are you referring to?
And Henrietta, would you verify for all to behold that there is truly coffee in here? Would you smell it? Somebody said
I'll vodka.
Check
for vodka.
Yes.
Oh, please.
Disappointing.
No, no it's vodka, delicious.
But
no,
excellent coffee.
No,
excellent
I don't want it to
excellent coffee.
I wanted to confirm. No. I wanted to confirm because, you see, there's a conspiracy theory out there. True story.
Can I remake that?
No.
I know that's Adamus and not Jeff because Jeff doesn't share a glass of anything with anybody, not one single sip.
Right.
Conspiracy theory.
You're making me look
and you know who you are out there. You know who you are. The theory goes that there is nothing in the cup. It's empty. And that I'm simply, it's a stage prop. That because Calder takes such fine, delicate sips. And they don't believe he's really drinking coffee. I caught you, didn't I? Huh? Yes, there is. Linda, verify, please. No, just look. A gaze is just fine.
What is your problem?
There is coffee in there. Don't make me start. Yes. So, but as you see, I love the coffee. It's actually Calder that's really drinking it, but he takes those fine, delicate sips as to not get foam all over his mustache. So, yes, he is drinking coffee. So, weird conspiracy theories, isn't it? I mean, it's really strange. Truly, Oshambra. Bonnie knows all about that. Oshambra writing in and wondering what sinister plots we have going on here with our coffee cups. I'm joking. So, dear Oshambra, let's take a good deep breath. I'm going to use the word meticulous, to describe the expectations that I have of you. High quality in every way, everything you do right now. Not trying to talk about being the perfect human, but I'm talking about in your endeavors, what you're doing in your life right now, do it with quality and class. I demand it of Crimson Circle. I demand that, as you can see, everything they do, it has to be energetically tuned. It has to be meticulous. They have to take care of the energy, kind of the composition. The little details take care of themselves, but they have to take great care. Why? Why with Crimson Circle? Why did I say 3 years ago, get your act together, get your house together? And they did. That was shocking, surprising, and wonderful. Everything top to bottom. They went through the organization and looked at it, and whether it was the technology, whether it was the creativity, whatever it was, and they've done an exemplary job of that. Because, you see, it sends a message, it communicates. And if you're meticulous, if you're doing a quality job, everything else will flow in quality in your life. And it's important for each and every one of you right now. This is, we'll talk about it today and up until March 22nd. This is not a joking matter. This isn't a light, humorous matter. I mean, it can be, but what you're doing right now, the reason you're on the planet is all about Heaven's Cross. And it even surprised us in the other realms. We did not anticipate it coming along this quickly. What you're doing in your life right now, do it with quality. Don't be sloppy. Don't do it hither yonder. Do it with quality. Be meticulous in everything you do. I expect that out of you. We don't gather like this and do a lot of processing. We don't do a lot of coddling. I'm very hard on so many of you so often because I know what's coming. This isn't just a fairy tale. This isn't just a kind of a what some of you call what a carrot, a feel good. This is happening right now. You will see it unfold in your own life and in the world. I know sometimes you've been disappointed, you've been let down by things, by different organizations you've been in the past, in past lives and this lifetime, by your own expectations and hopes. This, dear friends, is it. That's what you're here for. These next few months are going to be most interesting, and then what happens after that are going to simply be beyond on so many, so many levels. Everything is going to shift and change, and there are those of you who will handle it very well because you're prepared, you're doing it in a quality fashion. Those that are going to have a difficult time, still locked in the head, still being lethargic in what you do. Get off your ass right now if you are. Calder is telling me to shut up. And no, I mean it. This is it. This is go, no go right now. I know for you who are here, you listening online, that you have been truly following that inner knowingness in spite of all of the things that get in the way, in spite of what really is not yours. It's mass consciousness, but you take it on as your own. This is it. This is what we've came for. This is what Tobias has been working with you on for all these years, what then I came in and working with you on. This is what the Crimson Council is all about. This is it. And that's the good news. This is it. And you are going to be here, hopefully, to stay on the planet to experience exactly what's happening. It is the apocalypse. I'll talk about it more in a minute. This is the apocalypse, but not the dark, scary scenario that's been forced down into people's consciousness and beliefs. This is it right now. Here today as our guests, we have dear Tobias. He comes into a lot of the gatherings, and just he's kind of sitting in the cheap seats. he knows not to jump in too often. Once in a while, he's scolding me for something, but he hangs around quite a bit. And he's semi-retired, and you know, he just doesn't get too terribly involved in the direct work that we do. But feel into a moment. Our dear Tobias is here. And then, of course, Sam. Hello, Sam. Sam is going to be leaving in a few days. Well, I think he said December 21st, your time, he's going to be leaving. And I know it's brought up a lot of controversy, a lot of questions. Why would an Ascended Master come and to the planet? Why would an Ascended Master have to go through some of the pain and the grief? Why would an Ascended Master now leave so suddenly? He's only been here a few short years of time. It brings up a lot of questions, and that's good. Because it gets you to contemplate, why am I still here? And can I pull a Sam? You know, can I just walk through the apple orchard one early evening and just walk out? And I know some of you thought about it. If not an apple orchard, your own backyard. But it brings up a lot of questions. And it brings up a question of the challenges of living in this reality, this density. Even if an ascended master has to go through what he did, falling in love and then having Kelly die of COVID. As an ascended master, why couldn't he save her? Why couldn't he wave his ascended hand over her and clear her? And the answer is compassion. And the answer is also, to a large degree, Heaven's Cross. You see, back when Sam came in, the whole concept of Heaven's Cross, basically the melding now of the various dimensions, the ability to traverse into the other realms easily and gracefully, and the ability to have your divinity be right here with you, not in some far-off place. Back then, it wasn't even considered that it would be happening so soon. But things changed quickly, very quickly on the planet. As you remember, I predicted that COVID would come in and sweep the world and go away quickly. But you know, it was interesting because humanity embraced it. Well, it sounds strange to say they embraced COVID. Well, indeed, what they said is, this is an opportunity right now to make changes happen fast on the planet. Instead of coming in for just one sweep and creating a few changes, there was enough consciousness on the planet with humanity to say, let's keep it around for a while. It surprised me. It surprised so many on the other realms that there was this degree of the ability to change, make change on the planet, and that created such a shift in consciousness on so many levels. I know some of you have lost loved ones due to COVID. Some of you got it yourselves. And wasn't that interesting, Gene? Wasn't that interesting? A week in hell. But it was also a tremendous clearing. That created the opportunity for what we now know as Heaven's Cross to occur much, much sooner. There was questions, would it even happen, this Heaven's Cross even happen in the next couple of decades? And there was such a swift change at all levels that it is happening very soon. So part of the reason for Sam leaving isn't because he's sad or depressed about his life. It's to be on the other side. It's going to take you being here, and it's going to take other angelic beings, FM, Sart, Sam, and many, many others who you have known or perhaps didn't know that have left, because there's got to be the grounding of energies on this planet right now and the grounding on the other side. And you'd think perhaps, well, grounded on the other side, it's ethereal, it's non-physical. There still has to be a grounding, a balancing of energies on both sides. What's happening here in the physical is also played out and expressed and experienced in other non-physical realms. If it's not balanced there, it would be very, very difficult to bring the energies in here. So there's a lot of Chambra, a lot of dear ones that have gone to the other side, including Sam. He's not going away. He's just going to be there along with other Chambra who have departed and some Chambra who are still here on the planet, but working very actively in the other realms, very actively to assure this opening is done so very gracefully and so very personally. It has global effects, but ultimately is very, very personal. So Sam's not leaving because life was bad. And he experienced some tough stuff, but you know what he did? He brought it to wisdom. He brought it to wisdom. He made applesauce. He brought it to wisdom. And so it doesn't linger. There's no ghosts with it. It doesn't stay around. So yes, indeed, Sam's leaving in a few days, but wanted to make this one of the last stops on the way. Sam is here. Sam is right here. And you say, but I don't see him. I want to give him a kiss. I want to touch him. This is one of the things with Heaven's Cross, as things open up into both realms. You don't need to have that physical touch. No, physical touch is wonderful. But you suddenly start to realize you don't have to have it. It is just as real as to see Sam right back here. Sam, position yourself back there. In the snow, please. No, it's not that cold. In the snow. And take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. You can see him. And if your mind is saying, no, I can't, stop for a moment. There's a whole thing with Heaven's Cross. Yes, you can. Take a deep breath and just allow. Sam is right there. Interesting thing happened. So some of you are going back and forth, but I don't see anything. Try the alt right now. I do see something, and I'm not going to rely on my brain for it. I'm going to rely on my knowingness. Boom. I present Sam. Try going to the alt. I do see him. I know he's there. I know he's there. I have no problem seeing him. How's he dressed? He got dressed up today. He has on a clean flannel shirt, right? and relatively clean blue jeans. Yes, you do. So remember that in the future. Oh, I don't see anything. I don't get anything. Shut up. Yes, you do. It's right there. Behold it. It is right there. don't expect it to be totally physical. It'll have resemblances of physical, but you know, when you allow yourself to open up, you realize limiting yourself to just physical was really boring, uncolorful. You open up and you see Sam in his true glory, in his energy, and you're not making it up, not whatsoever. So yes, Sam, Tobias, you don't have to see him. But yes, absolutely here. And Tobias is chiming in. He wants to remind you, as we really go into these next few months, remind you and underline it a lot. You are not crazy. You are not crazy, and you haven't been crazy. Not whatsoever. You've allowed your intuition, your knowingness, to get you this far. And it's been tough at times, the battles you've had with your doubts. Doubts, such an awful thing. But now as you let that go, as you come to understand, you've never been crazy. Maybe other people thought you were. Maybe you judged yourself as that because it wasn't logical. But in Heaven's Cross, you realize it doesn't have to be logical at all. Quantum mechanics is not logical. If any of you understand a little bit about it, it defies logic, but yet it is real. And physicists know that these days. Having particles that talk to each other at great distances apart from each other, and yet with these great distances, the communications between the particles are instant. There's no time or space. Now, that's not logical, is it? But neither was the concept of a round Earth. So you're going to be discovering things that are not logical, and that's fine. Logic is good when you're trying to do certain tasks and certain things. But in Heaven's Cross, you're going to go beyond that. You're going to realize that little things we talk about sometimes in Keyhawk, but things that nothing exists without the observer. Nothing. No. There is not this wall back here. I'll use the coffee cup since some of you seem to think I'm drinking coffee. It doesn't exist until it's observed. What is it up until then? What is it? Waveforms? Waveforms. And the waveforms are nothing but potentials. And there's a lot of them. There's the potential. It's Schrodinger's cat. The cat is alive, the cat is dead. Which one is it? It depends on the observer. The potentials of this coffee cup are in waveforms right now. But with many other potentials, it's a red cup, it's a black cup. It's here, it's not here. And none of this is logical, is it? According to old belief systems, but according to true metaphysics, it makes perfect sense. It's not until you observe it that it becomes a black coffee cup filled with coffee, filled with coffee. And what happens is that waveform suddenly turns into, in your consciousness anyway, it turns into particles and then it becomes an object. My point is, where you are going may not appear logical. You may have a journey in front of you. And you're thinking, none of this makes sense. Why am I doing this? Where am I going with this? I must be crazy, you know, for it. But something inside is burning within you saying, no, you've got to do it. You've got to do this thing. And you fight yourself on the logic level, thinking that you have to be logical. What's going to happen if I don't apply my logic here? We're going to discover that logic is really old. The way logic has been practiced for a long time. And actually in with what they call classic science, that none of that actually really makes sense anymore. It's all changing so rapidly. And there are those who think that if you don't have logic, if you don't have the precision of mathematics and time, space, gravity, that if you don't have those elements, that it's not real. But that is not true at all. That's what you're going to discover with Heaven's Cross. You're going to be existing in both worlds, or I'm going to amend that, all realms. You'll still use logic at times, but it'll become less and less important. You suddenly start to realize that beyond logic is not chaos. Beyond logic is beauty that you've never beholded before in human form. Beyond logic is really makes so much more sense than being trapped in this reality. Tobias is saying, remember, you are not crazy. You're not making this up. I know there's times you think, I must be making this up because I'm just trying to be in denial of life. I'm trying to find some distraction, or this is a nice little hobby, or I love carrots in front of me, you know, and I keep going for them. I never seem to get them, but none of that is true. Unless you want it to be, and wouldn't that be sad? And that's the point you're at right now in your life. As we come to this Heaven's Cross, is it real or is it not? Am I real or am I not? Am I making this up or is it truly me? Is this all a bunch of mumble jumble and we get together once a month and we talk and I feel good for a little bit, but then it goes away? That's going to be up to you to decide. And you can go either way. If you go inside and really feel into it, you'll realize, I think you'll feel, you'll know that where you're going, where we're going, well, it's the apocalypse. I'll explain more about that in just a minute. Or you can say, this doesn't make sense. I think I'm going to go crazy if I keep going on this, if I dive into it. I can go back to living in a world of grayness, limitations, mass consciousness, logic, tightly bound physics, and all the rest of that. You go back to that for a little bit, and then you'll scream to get out because you know that there is so much more. Chambra is a very small group around the world, very small. And there are other groups, kind of similar, not as good, but kind of similar, that are exploring in depth. It's a small group, but you're the ones who came from Atlantis, the ones who we've talked to many times about developed the headbands or the technologies using infusions of light into crystal to stimulate the crystalline properties. And there's true physics in this. This wasn't a bunch of New Age stuff back then. It was really simple. Infusing light, high intensity focused light into crystals. And so many things could be done, including the headbands. And you've carried that weight with you for a long time. You, according to what Sam said in his talk, you're the ones now that are going to be releasing the headbands. You've done it on yourself. You're going to be doing it on a global scale. And that's what Heaven's Cross is. Imagine that for a moment. Releasing those headbands that have encased humanity now for a long time. But some will choose to keep them on. Some will choose to stay in limitations of mass consciousness. Others will celebrate the freedom that they now have. They won't know where it came from, how it came about, but suddenly they'll feel that huge release that's taking place. So let's take a deep breath together. I cannot tell you how how excited I am that this is here now. I'm glad we didn't have to wait another 5 years, 10 years, anything like that. It's here right now. Linda, are you excited?
Oh, so excited.
You can see that, you know, it's just oozing out of her. We're going to talk in just a minute about some of the things you're going through with it. But before we do that, I want to talk about the news.
I'm excited, but there's a lot to make all of us nervous. Am I the only nervous one? Jeez.
I want to talk for just a moment about the news. I know news makes so many of you nauseous. You don't listen to it. You don't read. You stay away from it. Sometimes that's a good idea because it's hypnotic. It's repetitive. And it's generally focused on reactions, drama, negative, in other words. But if you kind of keep a upper level perspective of the news right now, there's some exciting things happening. Not on the front page usually. But wasn't there an occurrence within the last week or so that hit the news that caused you to go, is this pro-nasty or what? What was that? Nuclear fusion. Fusion. What did they say about fusion? That it's been a theory for a long, long time. They just haven't really been able to do it. But now they've done it in the laboratory and repeated it numerous, numerous times. And the result of it was that the energy output was greater than the energy input. You should have all gone, boom, mic drop. I mean, this was so significant because really the entire purpose of the planet was the understanding of consciousness and energy. The entire past 100 years has been intensely focused on energy itself. And in the past, 20 or 30 years, has seen so much manipulation of economies, so many wars being fought over energy at the core. You know, energy and power, they're cousins, they're very well related. And now this breakthrough that they have shown it to be true, it'll be what they say a decade, I think it'll be sooner than that, a decade before it's put into practical application, because it's going to take a while to develop the technology and get it distributed. I think it's going to happen faster because you're going to see a flow of money going into it, investors or governments. You're going to see tremendous amount of attention. The ability to create more energy than the initial input and clean energy, not what you have right now, not the pollution. And you know, don't fool yourselves, please. Electric cars, please. You know, you don't get a special medal for driving an electric car because you're cleaning up the environment. It still pollutes on many, many levels. All right, Calder's giving me crap again, but and maybe not as bad as a regular gasoline engine, but it still pollutes. Imagine now the accessibility to free, clean energy. And it won't be free, by the way. Everybody's going to want a little bit of it, but it'll be a whole lot more economical than what it is now. And it will be clean. Imagine how that changes the world, the power players of the world. That was the last thing they wanted to hear last week was nuclear fusion. And they're literally, I've been watching this with great interest, but they're starting their machinery up to do the negative publicity about it. Mm-hmm. It's dangerous and it'll never happen and don't put your money into it. They're vested into old energy under the ground. And their whole hierarchy, their whole distribution, they're getting very nervous right now, and they should be. Can you imagine a world, let's say even 20 years from now, where it's readily manufactured and distributed, and it's free and clean? How that changes the world, the environment, the economics, and the freedom. And the interesting thing was when this news came out, about that was a big gulp, wasn't it? we're joking. The interesting thing was I kind of scratched my head because this wasn't the top candidate. There's still one other even better potential for new energy, free energy on the planet, and it has to do with a combination of gravity and magnetics. And they're so close right now. In the laboratory testing, they're so close. It's understanding the relationship between of gravity in the first place. Science doesn't really know what gravity is. They know if I drop this cup, it's going to fall, but that's about it. They don't understand energetically what's happening with gravity. Once you understand that, you can truly harness it for your use. That and magnetics combined. That has more potential, faster potential And I'm going to say, I'm going to go out on a limb. I'm going to say in the next 18 months, there'll be interesting news about that. And a better alternative even to fusion. You're seeing it right before your eyes on the planet, and it's going to change everything. It's going to change everything. The planet right now is manipulated by energy, by oil, and that's all going to change. And I'm going to step back a little bit and say, so why is it all changing? Why did Heaven's Cross come sooner than what we thought? Why are all these changes happening? Why are you going through the intensity that you've been going through recently? And it comes back to a very simple thing, two simple things that are connected. Allowing. You're finally getting okay with allowing. I'm not going to give you an A for it yet, but you get a B minus, but at least we're beyond a C. You finally are getting it. Before, you'd sit down and allow, and it was like your sphincter was tightened, and you can't allow with a tight butt. And I mean butt in both senses of the terms, but and butt. And you finally, maybe you're exhausted. Maybe you're just whatever. Maybe we should have just called it that, huh? Instead of allowing, you know, whatever. And you're like, I'm just letting it in. Not the whole world. I'm letting me in. Whatever. So allowing. And the other thing, so important, I think you've forgotten about it, the importance of it, benching. You know, we started this whole benching push a couple of years ago, last series called Benching. You're like, yeah, I'm benching. I don't see anything happening. You know, geez, the world's still like it was. No, it's changing everything. Sitting your butt down, your relaxed butt down, and not your sphincter butt, your relaxed butt, and letting that light shine. That's why things like nuclear fusion and the soon-to-be gravity magnetic energy, and that's why so many other things are changing. You sat down and benched, and you expected, what, all the wars to end on the planet tomorrow? Yes, okay, smart ass over there. You get up here and do this. There's a ripple effect taking place right now, and it's happening all over the world from the benching. And it's gonna continue. So please continue to bench, but don't expect that suddenly the traffic will get lighter because you're benching. You have to look at the big perspective. I mean, the big perspective of where the light is going to, what it's doing. And this planet was long overdue for an energy change, and it was just waiting. It, you know, the theory's been there. A lot of great theories out there that aren't going to see the quote light of day until the consciousness is there. A lot of great theories. And what happened is there was enough light to make enough change at the laboratory in California where some engineer, physicist is trying to figure out the problem on how is this, why isn't this working? How come we just can't do it? And then suddenly, oh, I get it. And he rushes off to the boss and says, look, I got this great solution to the problem. And of course the boss, it's like, I don't think that's going to work. But this engineer, this or physicist is pushing and said, no, this will work. And there's something is pushing him. Something is motivating him to keep going. And it's all that light that's coming in. That's what you're doing. And I know so often you sit on the bench and nothing's happening. Tobias. That was what you call an ascended master fart.
Right. It blew out the TV.
Right.
It blew out the monitor.
Right here. Oh, jeez. Anyway, so this was big news, and expect a lot of other big news. It doesn't mean you have to read the paper every day, but just keep your eyes and ears open for what comes up. Maybe other Schomburg could help share some of this news for those of you who are adverse to it, but it's just beginning. And that's the exciting thing. This planet is going to change so much in these coming years and decades, so much. And you can sit back with a big smile on your face like that. Nobody's going to give you an award. I might, but they're not going to know you're doing it. They're going to think you're still a whack job. But but if you look back on what we've been talking about over the years, it all starts falling into place. So let's take a good deep breath with that. We're about to go into a new year, 2022. How was it for you? Linda, microphone, please. And I do this so everybody watching and online, you can feel into it. A lot of times I think you feel alone in your thoughts or feelings. But watch how, as we go around with the microphone, you can relate and you go, that's what was happening to me too. I wasn't the only one. 2022, how was that year? Is it the best year ever or what? Linda, please find a volunteer. Yes. Yes, darling.
Getting into my sovereignty.
Yeah.
Separating myself from all the things that weren't working.
Right, right.
Being alone.
Being alone. Was it a tough year?
Yeah.
How tough? Scale of 1 to 10.
I've had tougher years.
Yeah, that's
it
a good consolation prize.
Yeah, it was probably 7.
7,
eight.
That's pretty tough. Okay. Yeah. Why?
Resistance on my part.
Yeah. Or?
Change.
Or
allowing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't want to give away my answer yet.
You want me to say something else?
Play this thing out. No, just say whatever you want. Tough year. Okay.
Yeah.
That's a toughie. Linda? 2022. Would you want to do it all over again? Hi, Annette.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. Good. Better?
You came a long way to see Shambra.
Yes.
But mostly me?
Yes. No, all of you guys. Yeah.
So we had a talk a couple of years ago. You were sitting right over there.
Yes, I was.
And, the energies that came flowing through that affected Shambra all around the world. The sadness, almost a desperation. How are things now?
Much better.
Good. I'm glad you said that.
Yeah,
I would have looked like a fool.
I don't think I would be here if not.
Yes.
Because I feel I managed to ground a lot of the energies that was making the resistance.
Right, right.
And so actually I think this year was kind of a better year for me.
Yeah.
Like a
there's
good
still
year.
Something there's still something holding a kind of weighing on your shoulders. What is it?
Then I need to ask you, I think. You can tell me.
Sure, and then I'll ask you back, and we'll play this game back and forth. And anybody have a tennis ball here?
No, of course it's to not believe that I'm crazy, to trust myself.
Right.
I think
we could change that right away.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, so a show of hands. How many people think Annette is crazy? Please raise your hand.
No, I...
How many of you can feel what she's going through and, kind of going through these challenging times, thinking it's your own, but it's really not? How many feel that way? See, you're not crazy.
Yeah,
I just proved it.
Yeah,
that is a scientific approach.
Yeah.
And if anybody had raised their hand on the first one, boom. They'd have been over with Tobias and Sam.
I feel pretty safe, but there's a little bit left.
Sure, you're living in a tough world. I mean, and do you still have some of the family issues with your son?
Not that much.
Not that much.
I believe and feel myself that I've been able to untangle myself out of it and in a very different way that surprises the others. Mm-hmm. Like, the health systems, they are just like looking at me, what are you saying? Are you saying no to take care of your son?
Yeah.
They're like, who are you? Why are you?
You say, of course, I'm a master.
No,
just do what I say.
No, I can't.
Try it.
I cannot.
No, try it. It's great. I'm a master. Yeah. Watch their expression.
Yeah.
But you
then
have to say it.
Be able to
you have to say it with confidence. Hello, I'm a master. Rather than, I'm a master?
Yeah.
No, it's a,
yeah.
And you look him in the eye. I'm a master. Solve my problem.
Yeah, seriously?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm.
Can I say that?
Sure.
To them?
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, why wouldn't you?
Yeah, but what will happen
after? Oh, I'm just a little person, and I have no control over anything, and I'm just a... No. Hello, I'm a master.
They will hospitalize me.
No, that's where I want to challenge you.
Yeah.
Number one of several things happened. They don't hear it. They just don't hear it.
Like the on
a human level.
The painting back
there?
The
naked painting, yes. Yeah. The Pope didn't see me.
No,
yeah.
So actually they will, okay.
They don't either don't hear you or they're so surprised because they're used to dealing with, you know, the likes of you, others all day long. And all they want to do is hit 4 o'clock on the clock and get the hell out of there and stop. They just want to get rid of you. But suddenly you're like, hello, I'm a master. And this problem will get solved, right?
Yeah.
And they're shocked. And they might throw back energy right away, but you just, I am a master. No, try it. What's the worst that's going to happen?
That I'm not going to be able to visit my son anymore?
No, that'll never happen.
No.
Never happen.
No, it's just my fear of
that. So you get all these worries and fears, and I can't do this, and I can't do that, and it's... One of the things that's happening right now with Heaven's Cross is that suddenly you have access to these, your full realms of self. And while that sounds really good, it's going to be a challenge. Every one of you is going to be challenged. Well, maybe I should just shy back.
Yeah, can I really be outside in that world, but I am home inside with myself?
You're in the alt. You're both.
That we can really do that?
No, you can't. I was fooling the whole time. No, you can't. Yes, dear. Yes. But that's the thing, because you're going to wonder, all of you are going to wonder, can I really do this? Should I do it? Maybe I should let other people go first. Maybe I'm going to hold back. Maybe I should do it halfway. Maybe I won't do it at all. Maybe this is all a dream. Maybe I should just conform and get back into line with everything. No, this is it. You do it. You do it. You break through, and it's scary as hell at first because you're like, oh, my God, this is do or die. This is the big step. This is the quantum step in things. And you do it, and you're like, why didn't Adamus tell me to do it sooner? Because it's so freeing, and it's so easy. And I don't have to manipulate energies. I don't have to play games in my mind. I just have to be who I am and allow in all that I am into this realm. I walk in all the worlds, and I can be in all worlds. I can be in just some worlds when I choose to be. I can be in all realms. I can be in just one realm.
Okay.
And it's so liberating. But you got to break through, all of you got to break through that thing of, am I crazy? Should I be doing this? I'll go so far as to say, you really don't have a choice right now.
It's not that I feel that crazy myself any longer, but I'm afraid of their reaction.
Why? Why are you thinking their reaction is going to be one of, she's crazy? Why don't you alt that? And their reaction is going to be respect.
Okay.
And their reaction is going to be shock at first because they're not used to the likes of you walking in. And there may even be some pushback on it, but they're just, the pushback is only testing you. That's all it is. Every one of you is going to be challenged for these next few months in particular about living your dreams, not just dreaming them. You dreamt your dreams long, long, long enough. And now it's time to live them, to bring them here, to be them. This whole philosophical discussion of the divinity and the soul and all the rest of that, it makes for a real nice little fairy tale thing, or very real. And you're going to be challenged. Are you ready for it? Can you do it? Can you take the steps you're talking about? You know, can you walk into this institution and have that masterly countenance about you? And if you need to, say the words, hello, I'm a master, and we're gonna take care of this situation. But you walk in there going, God, I'm a terrible mother, you know, and what am I doing? What are they going to think?
Yeah.
Fuck them. Sam, stop making me swear.
So it would be appropriate to...
Why? Can you believe his language for an ascended master?
Yes, of course.
No. It doesn't matter what they think at all. The world right now, I can't say this enough, the world right now wants every one of you to wear your big boy pants, to be who you are. They're desperate for some type of true standard, desperate. Who do they have to look to in the world right now? I mean, think of a few names of, you know, the ones who are, who?
Donald Trump.
Putin, Biden, you name them. Really? You know, religious leaders, the Pope, God bless his soul, and all the rest of that. But they want somebody that can walk and talk like a master. And that's what you're going to start doing. You know, you are going to start doing.
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Yes, I am.
And you're going to do it with grace and dignity
and
clarity.
Yes. Yes, I am.
And it can really scare you the first time. And there's every one of you is facing some issue in your life. Oh, how do I handle this? And then you drive yourself crazy. And oftentimes you don't do it. You back down from doing it. And some of you actually, in spite of all the logic and in spite of all the reasons you shouldn't do something, you do it anyway. Mm. You follow what you call your heart. You follow your knowingness. And it's excruciating. Maybe it can be really tough. But once you do it, you go, why did I ever doubt? I'm not crazy. I was crazy to stay back there. And that's what Heaven's Cross is challenging every one of you right now. Not intentionally. I'm not trying to give you a hard time, but it's there. Do you want it or not? It's accessible, but you gulp and say, I'm not sure if I can handle it, or maybe I'm crazy. No. I'm going to be pushing every one of you, nicely, of course, in my own charming way. Let's get on with stuff here now, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
You bet. Okay. We're not... getting very far with this, but two more. For how was the year? And thank you for letting me be intense.
I tried all sorts of reverse psychology. Ah, not today. Yeah, I want the mic.
Who, me?
I love you. My year was interesting.
Yeah.
So on the one hand, internally really expansive dreams that are just wow.
Yeah,
wow.
Dreams. Really? How many wow. Weird dreams?
Wow.
Crazy dreams. How many? You can raise them high. You're not crazy.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then on the other hand, this kind of physical grounding, things like Achilles tendon that's like screwed up. And it makes sense, you know, but you still go, gosh.
I know.
You know?
So how many body aches and pains, you know, something that really kind of holds you back from normal everyday activities in life? Okay. You're not crazy. That's what's happening right now. Go ahead.
Yeah. That's it. That's
okay. Kind of, happiness level?
Off the scale.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
You look great.
You look great, by the way. You're just glowing.
Glowing.
Yeah.
Silver hair.
That had to be it. No, you could tell. You've come to, say, peace within yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the battling. You're a good battler. You're a great warrior.
Yeah.
But you're like, not so fun anymore.
Yeah. Benching's fun.
It is fun. It is fun. You know, you get to, some of you are just people watchers anyway, and you get to bench and watch people and not give a damn about little things anymore.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Thank you. One more.
Okay.
Andy, good to see you.
Yeah. Hi, Adamus. Good to see you as well.
Thank you. But do you really see me? Are you seeing Caldera, or are you really seeing me?
Well, I'm seeing Caldera right now, and I look forward to a little more of an opening.
Opening with him?
No.
Oh, with
opening
you.
Opening with me.
With you, okay.
Yeah.
What's not open?
I seem to have some aspects around that still get angry.
Really?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Why? About what?
Some of your words.
You're telling me that you like me, but your aspects don't like me.
Pretty much. Say that. Yeah.
Why don't you have your aspects come and talk to me sometime?
I think we've been talking quite a bit.
Yeah, they're talking to you, not to me.
I'll send them on into you.
So what's their complaint? And what could they possibly be complaining about?
You're making promises that everything's going to be just wonderful.
Oh, no. I'm about to tell you in a few moments here after this lead-up that things are going to be really tough. No promises.
Well, I mean, you tell me to kick back, take it easy. It's all going to work out. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I've heard that story before. Mm-hmm. It didn't work out real good.
What didn't work out? You're here. You know. You got a great T-shirt on.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah. Believe.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So what didn't work out, Andy?
I guess I did not expect the emotional pain last year.
What happened? I mean, did somebody do something to you?
No. I'm fine, but I'm...
Well, hang on a second. I'm very confused. Well, emotional pain. What are you talking... Are you crying at night?
Well, sometimes, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. The people around me are... I guess as I see more, there's some ugly shit out there.
No.
And maybe I'm just realizing... How ugly it can be.
When did this happen? Jeez, I haven't been on the planet in hundreds of years. No, really?
Well, see, you're missing out. You know, I've always wanted to experience.
Andy, are you surprised that there's some crap out there?
No, I guess I'm surprised it's so personal.
Personal? You mean within a person or within you?
Well, let's see. This year I got them... I got to watch my son pried out of a car in a near-death accident. My wife had cancer removed. It was very emotional.
I can understand, but those aren't yours.
No, but I'm in the middle
of
it.
And can you have enough compassion to accept that this is what, on a level, this is what they were choosing?
Yes.
And that you didn't cause it?
Yes.
And that you can't cure it?
That's hard because
Sam's girlfriend, love of his life, died. Kelly.
Yeah.
Now it hurt him a lot. He was able to bring that to wisdom after the grieving. He allowed himself that.
Yes.
After the grieving, and with the wisdom, he understood the reason why. And looking at it from a human perspective, it really hurt. Looking at it from you could say the divine level, it made perfect sense.
Yes. However, the human feels it. I mean,
Yes.
I feel a lot.
Yeah.
And some of the feelings aren't so good, you know.
No.
But, you know, I signed up for it. I'm here. I'm going to be there.
Right.
I'm on the road. I'm doing this. I want to do it all.
Yeah. So is it a carrot?
I've seen these carrots before and chased them.
Yes.
I guess that's what upset me about Heaven's Cross was that, you know, I'm here and, kick back. It'll be all right.
Right.
I remember a lot of times where I've been told that before. And
when?
Maybe some past lives.
Exactly. So often, particularly so often in religious orders, in spiritual groups, so often in past lifetimes, and they missed it. You know, they felt that something was going to happen. They just missed it by a couple thousand years or more. And, you know, the whole concept of the new energy, the new earth, the whole concept of the second coming of Christ, been around for a long time.
A long time.
And there are some, intentionally or not intentionally, that ride that horse, that will use that, maybe feeling into the truth of it, but then using that, you know, for power, for whatever. There's been a lot of that. And it's always the prophecy, what's, you know, off in the future somewhere, and, you know, suffer while you're here on earth so you can be in heaven on the other side. It's all crap.
It is crap.
It is.
It is. Yeah.
And the only thing I can say about all this right now is that you're going to know it that something is happening if you're feeling a super intensity in your life within yourself right now. And then ultimately watch to see what happens. But if you're feeling nothing, if this is just another mental exercise and then just like another whoopee, you know, then it's not real. If you're feeling that something is going on almost an unprecedented level within you that doesn't necessarily make a lot of sense, you don't know what it is, but it's so overwhelming that you want to cry, that you are almost incapacitated by it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then you know it's real. It's not because I'm prophesizing it. It's because of what each and every one of you are going through and are going to go through between now and then and to a degree afterwards. And it's not going to be fun. And you're going to feel things like you've never felt before. And those aspects are going to be roaring more than ever before, because it's all part of deciding, are you going to just stay here on the planet in this duality base, or are you going to allow yourself to transcend? Not going off out there, you know, to live in some la-la land.
No.
But to open that up and let it come in.
Right here.
Right here.
Right here.
And it's, I'm not doing it. We're not doing it as a group. It's a very, very personal thing for each and every one of you. Truly very personal. It's, there's so many different ways to describe it, but it is, the intensity of it is almost unimaginable. And yeah. I'm gonna tell everybody right now, some of you are going to feel it so very intensely, deeply within you, and you're going to have a temptation to find ways to escape it, because you say, I cannot stand the intensity anymore. As we approach this date, please, 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 no matter what you do, drink yourself a bottle a night of Jack Daniels or whatever it is. Please do not take the antidepressants, the anxiety medications. And there could be a temptation if you've ever done them before, because it's like it does kind of flatten everything. But what's happening, all this turmoil needs to come right now. And the dragon is working overtime.
Yeah.
And yeah. And there's a lot of releasing, that last the last releasings that are taking place. And then the big question that comes to each and every one of you personally is, can I let myself go to the point of letting go of all the logic and the am I crazy? Can I just let it happen? Can I just allow on my own personal level what I've sought for so many lifetimes, to know the God within, to know all that I am, to know the divinity, and to have it right here, not as a nebulous concept, not as some lofty philosophical thing, but damn it, right here in right your here. Life. And it's going to kick your ass. It's going to, you're literally, I mean.
My ass is sore.
I
got bursitis now. Yeah,
exactly. Exactly. So this is what I get.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I know it's very, very intense right now. And it's one of the things I wanted to talk about today. We'll be talking about in our upcoming sessions, the super intensity. If you're not feeling anything right now, you know, you're probably not Chambra. That's all I can say. There is such turmoil going on. But it's asking that final, you know, this isn't just a warm-up or a dress rehearsal. It's asking that final question. Are you really ready, Andy, to bring it in? Even if the rest of the planet doesn't, even if I'm so different than others, even if it twists and turns and shakes up all of my belief systems.
I've always known I was different than
we all knew
many
that.
Others.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to, I didn't want to miss anything.
Right.
I still don't.
Yeah.
I still want to be here and have all of me here.
Yeah.
I guess I just didn't think, there's that think again, I didn't think it would be quite so challenging. I thought, hey, I'm ready. I can handle anything.
Sure, and part of the reason it's challenging is because it's happening sooner than what you or anybody would have expected. You know, Shambra, they're you're interesting. It's like Tobias once said, all this going into enlightenment and realization would take 3 to 4, maybe 5 lifetimes. And all of you are like, well, that's crap. We're going to do it in one.
Yeah. Yeah.
And not just one, but in like a compressed period of about 20 years. So it's very super compressed. And that's what has brought Heaven's Cross here sooner than what we would have possibly imagined. And it's here. And now it's right in front of you, in front of us. And it's saying, basically, are you ready to stop dreaming your dreams and live your dreams? Are you ready to stop just having it out there somewhere? And maybe you tinker around with it on the other realms. Are you really ready to bring it here? And that, just feel into that. You can give the mic back to Linda.
I'm going to lecture for a little bit.
Yeah. Imagine
Thank
that.
You.
You know, lifetimes of so many of you in religious orders, and the promise, the search, and that got to be the addiction, and always looking for the answers, always waiting for the prophecy off in the future somewhere. Suddenly, it's here, and that is a no shit statement. Suddenly, it's here. You know, it's like looking for something all your life and not finding it, and then you get used to looking for things, and that's what you become as a looker. And suddenly it's there, and it's like, whoa, hang on a second. Am I ready? You know, I've spent my whole life or lifetimes looking and searching, and it's here. And then all the crap comes up. And the dragon is like, oh, man, I got to work not just 24 hours a day, 48 hours a day. And it's like, am I ready for it? Am I worthy? Am I crazy? And should I follow my knowingness, or maybe I should put the brakes on? Maybe both. That's a tough one. Either hit the brakes or hit the gas. Don't do both. Suddenly it's here and is bringing up tremendous things like anxiety, questioning yourself, wondering if this is just another carrot. Sure, if you want it to be. It could be another carrot, or it could be for real. And that's what you're faced with right now. Is this real? Am I real? It's a, what Calder's saying, it's an oh crap moment. You just do it or not. The level of stress, anxiety, tension, all the rest of that is at, with Shambra in general around the world, at an all time high. Some of you haven't felt it, the full effect yet. You will before we get to that March 22nd date. And on that date, again, nothing particularly magical happens, maybe, but not much. But on that date, the you could say the other realms open up. The accessibility to your divinity, whatever you want to call it, your soul, your divinity, your real self opens up. And the analogy I gave Calder before was like this. Imagine that your soul is a great big tall building, 44 floors. It's very tall. And the human exists down on that lower level, level zero, ground floor level. And that's where the human exists. The human is kind of aware that there's a great big building above, but doesn't think too much about it. The human's tied up with that ground floor level and all the problems and the plumbing and the other people and the heating system and the blown electric fuses, and kind of knows something's there. And once in a while has tried to go there and has found like way off on the ground floor somewhere there's a stairwell and it's marked do not enter. But the human says, well, what the hell, I'm going to open the door. Opens the door and there's this stairwell. And it's dark, obviously hasn't been maintained in ages, and it's kind of scary. And the human starts to walk up a few steps. The steps are creaking, and the walls on the sides are starting to crumble a little bit, and there's eerie noises. Ooh, kind of eerie. We tried. eerie noises, and And then the human starts to get a little nauseous, and it's like, maybe I shouldn't be going here. I read about this, you know. This is like maybe devil's play. Maybe I shouldn't. But, you know, the human being the human keeps going and finally gets up to the next level and tries to open the door going into the second floor or first floor, tries to open the door, and it's locked. So the human goes back down and lives on the ground level. And then comes back the next lifetime and goes through the whole thing again, finding the stairwell, says, do not enter, going up to the first floor, breaks down the door and goes up, tries to go up to the second floor, but and the stairwell is just filled with litter and debris and crap, and it stinks really bad, and there's rats all over. So the human goes back down to the ground floor, next lifetime, goes to the third floor. You get the point. Tries to go up, and yeah, we can end the story there. We got it. Did I tell you about my 100,000 years in the crystal? So, over lifetimes, trying to access this, trying to get to the upper floors, but never really that successful. Yet along the way, hears noises and feels things, and you know, really has a sense. Okay, there are some other floors here, but I don't know what they are. And one day, the soul comes to the human and says, "Human, hey, everything you've been doing, all this work, you're doing it the hard way. There's an easy way, and it's because of your light. I want to show you something." And the soul, kind of representative of a big golden angel, kind of looks like me, and says, "I want to show you something," and takes the human right outside the building and said, "Look at this." The human's like, "What is that?" I says, "That's a glass elevator. It's on the outside of the building, so you can see everything. You're aware of everything. It's a glass elevator. It'll take you straight up to 44. Let's go." Hop in the elevator, and just on its own, no button pushing or anything, on its own, it whisks them off up to the 44th level, right in the presence of the soul. And of course, at that moment, the human goes, "Oh, no, I'm making this all up. I'm crazy. I'm nuts. This is stupid. Humans don't see angels. They don't ride on glass elevators to the top of the 44th building. And how could the soul be a building anyway? This is all nuts. I'm going back down." And the soul grabs the human by the shoulder and says, "Shut up. Human, shut the fuck up. You are on the 44th floor. Look around you, observe, feel. It's different, it's free. Not only that, let me take you up to the rooftop." Walks up to the rooftop, opens up, and can see forever. Says, "Breathe that air, feel the sun, feel the freedom up here. It's so free up here, I could take you, dear human, and throw you off the roof, which I'd like to do, but you would fly. This is the realm of the I am and the soul and the human all together. This is heaven's cross. This is what you've sought for, but you were afraid. This is what you've gone up some dingy, dirty stairwell trying to find over lifetimes and lifetimes, and now it's here and you doubt it? You are so human. Dear human, take a deep breath. You have earned this. This is the express elevator, and it can go back and forth all the time. You can stop at level 34 and visit past lives. You can stop at level 11 and watch how there are parts of yourself that know how to transcend time, space, gravity. You're not locked in that continuum down there called the ground floor. You can go anywhere you want. And the interesting thing about this wonderful magic elevator that you created, by the way, this glass elevator, is that you can be in multiple floors at the same time, or all floors at the same time, or you can go back down to that despicable ground floor and just be there if you want, but then knowing you can get out at any moment and visit all of yourself. That's heaven's cross. It's the express elevator. It traverses back and forth with ease. And what's happening right now is you're preparing for it energetically and in every way as the human. As you're preparing, you're saying, "I don't know. Maybe I'm making it up. Maybe there is no glass elevator. Maybe there are no other floors. Maybe this is all there is. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I should seek help. Maybe I should run away. Maybe I should just die. Maybe I should just go to the other realms, which has nothing to do with this building and my soul." And that's what's happening right now. There's a lot of confusion, a lot of consternation, a lot of anxiety, because this is it. You know, when you get so, when you're right there, which we are, and you're like, "Oh, crap. then you start thinking, why have I wasted all these lifetimes? Why didn't this come sooner? What did I do wrong to delay this for so very long? What if the glass elevator crashes? It's like, human, just get on the thing and let it whisk you to the top and then bring your soul back down with you. That's what you're going to do. You're going to get on this thing, you're going to go up there, and you're going to bring the essence of your soul back down with you. And I know that ground floor is really dirty. You haven't cleaned it forever. And I know it's messy down there. And I know you're on that ground floor and the city traffic and the noise and everything else. And maybe you don't think you're worthy of having it, but give it a try, would you? Just bring all of you back down with you and then watch what happens. Watch what transforms in your life. You're getting the jitters before you get on that elevator. Is it real? It's up to you. Are you going crazy? Maybe, but what's crazier? Living in that ground floor forever with that whole big building above you, never being able to get to those other floors and levels? What's crazier? You're being challenged with feeling, the feeling, I gotta make everything right down here on ground floor. I gotta clean it up. I'm not ready. Shut up. You're ready. The messes tend to clean themselves up. But yes, throw out some of the stuff that you've been clinging to, some of the old junk. Clean it out. But, you know, you don't have to make it a perfect space. You find out that on that 44th floor, it is the perfect space, and you're going to bring it back down here. And that has a way of cleaning everything out. You're being challenged by your aspects, Andy, that are saying, oh, you know, this is all a big promise and that, and nothing's going to happen, Andy, so just sit down and don't do anything and stop dreaming like this. You know, you're fooling yourself, Andy. Every one of you knows better until the mind jumps in. Every one of you knows that you have these dreams. You have a knowingness. We've been doing this for a long, long time. It's here now. Every one of you has that knowingness, but it takes a lot of courage to take that step and go for it. In spite of everything that the logic is telling you, in spite of thinking that you're crazy, in spite of worrying about what might happen, you just do it. You get on that elevator. Maybe you close your eyes and go, dear God, what am I doing? You get on that elevator and you go to soul and then bring soul back here. It's like that. Yes, a lot of anxiety right now, a lot of tension, a lot of the energies that are coming in right now into your personal life, forget about the planet, are so intense right now. And so much readjusting and reorienting and cleaning up and getting ready for. But it's time now that each and every one of you lived the dream, brought it here, not having it up there somewhere. That's what's happening. It's going to be challenging, and that's why there are so many in the other realms who are gathered around. That's why Sam left. Sam could have hung around Earth for a long time, but he knows the importance of what's happening right now. Somebody has to be the balance in the other realms on all the floors that you get off on, but particularly soul level. Make sure that you're balanced when you get there. Make sure the energies are, it doesn't fry you to a crisp. It doesn't absolutely burn you out. That you're able to have human and divine meet and come here and coexist together. So, I say this is the apocalyptic event, and it is. And I know Calder is saying, oh, it sounds so grandiose. Duh. It is. You know what apocalyptic means in Greek? To reveal, to pull the lid off, to take aside the things that are preventing you from seeing. That's what apocalypse means. Not death and destruction and Revelations of John, it wasn't about the horrific events coming to the world and destroying the world. Revelations, if you reread it now with the eyes of Heaven's Cross, you realize the beauty in Revelations. You realize it was saying that there is this new age coming to earth, and it literally says in Revelations, it is time of God to be with humanity. It says that, time of God. Time of your divinity to be with your human. It says that right there. It's very clear. It says this is the new age, the new energy, not the end of the world. Those who hang on to power and greed and those who are trying to maintain the old ways of control and structure, those who are opposed to true freedom, they're not going to last. They will not make it. They will go to another earth somewhere so they can play with their buddies who are all into power games and their addictions and their abuse and everything else. There is an earth that has been created just for them. They won't know the difference. They're not going to know the difference from one day to the next, but they'll suddenly be there. And this earth that you're living on right now, it's going to go through so many changes, and it's going to be rough getting there, but it's going to go through changes that bring it into what's been termed singularity. I term it as true freedom. And that's what you're going through, and that's what you've been doing for so very long, working at it. And I know you're exhausted. You run a marathon, and what's the hardest part? It's that last leg, the last mile. Not the middle ones, it's that last one, because your body is saying, it's right there in front of me. If any of you ever run a marathon, you know it. And it's like, you can see the finish line, but suddenly your body is shaking. Suddenly the energy isn't flowing. Suddenly every muscle hurts. Suddenly all the mental, the focus that you've had goes out, and you wonder if you can make it. You know, it happens pretty often, but they collapse right before the finish line. It's what they've worked on so hard, and almost as part they can't imagine that they're there, that they made it. And that's what we're doing right now. That last, it's not the last mile, it's the last moments. There's a lot happening between now and then, and I know I've gone long here, but I do want to do an important marab here. We're going to talk more about Heaven's Cross. Take a deep breath. It's tough. I mean, not bad tough, good tough right now, super intense. And I know I can list these things, and I'll ask Calder to write them up for later, but, you know, sometimes you just want to cry, and you just want to cry. Sometimes you just, it's so intense in your body and your mind, you don't know if you can get by. And sometimes it's so confusing what's right and what's wrong. When you're trying to determine, am I crazy, am I not, am I making this up, what's going on? You're just coming to Heaven's Cross. That's it. That's it. Let's take a good deep breath. And in the spirit of Sam, let's bring on the marab. What's happening to you right now is very similar to what happened with Sam, particularly after his loved one, Kelly, died. There was a grieving. You're grieving many, many lifetimes right now. Oh, by the way, I forgot to add, every one of your past lives is coming to this point also. Every one of them is going through that shaking and rattling. Every one of them is feeling something so intense. They're coming to Heaven's Cross too. You don't do it by yourself. It's every past life. They're realizing their dreams. They may have been in a monastery or a convent. They might have been back in the Essenes. No matter where they are, they're coming to this also. They're asking that same question I was asked earlier. Are we just making this up? they're saying something's happening. Are we just making this up? Maybe I should get back and do prayers again. Go back and kneel in the chapel and pray to God for my soul. They're going through it also. What's happening right now, it happened to Sam, is there is a grieving that takes place. He grieved for Kelly. You're grieving for yourself. For all the painful experiences in all the lifetimes. You're grieving for your own deaths. You're grieving that part of you that's saying, why? Why didn't I get it before? Grieving the part that knows that you could have truly, literally ascended several lifetimes ago, but you didn't. I think maybe I should have. But remember, you chose to stay. What's happening right now is in every part of you, you're being asked to or forced to bring everything to wisdom. That's what Sam had to do. After his grieving for Kelly, he brought it to wisdom. And by releasing it to the wisdom of your soul, it provides clarity, why things happen the way they do sometimes, and the beauty of it. When you're in the exact moment of something tough happening, you know, for instance, a loved one having cancer, pulling a loved one from a car, like what you were talking about before, it's hard to be in the wisdom, very hard. No, don't even try. Be in the grieving, be in the even the fright, but then bring it to wisdom at a certain point, and you'll understand from an overview, from Angel's Peak, what's happening. And you realize the profound beauty, and even what you would have thought was a mistake, an accident, profound beauty. As we approach Heaven's Cross, let go of everything to wisdom, no longer holding it on as painful, no longer having to punish yourself. Let it go to wisdom right now. The soul, it will bring it to wisdom. It'll help show you the beauty. Yes, even in the worst things. All the intensities, all the noises right now, all the challenges that you're having, physical, mental, spiritual, it all comes down to this. This single thing. Bring it to wisdom. That's it. That's what's happening. It's, can you let it go from a state of grieving, a state of fear, a state of not loving yourself, and let it go to wisdom? Your soul knows what to do with it. Then you don't have to do a thing, but can you let it go? That's a summary of everything that's happening. Why hang on to things? Unless you want to, if you want to continue experiencing guilt and shame, for instance. But sooner or later, the closer we get to Heaven's Cross, your soul is going to shake you and say, let go, Annette, let go. Elizabeth, why do you keep carrying that with you? Let go, let it go to wisdom, please. Please, you cannot go into Heaven's Cross until you let it go to wisdom. That's the elevator. The elevator is truly wisdom. You can't keep carrying it with you and feeling guilty about things that happened in the past. And I know some of you, it's tough to let those go. You feel it's your cross to bear, but now it's time for heaven's cross. Not the cross of guilt. It's time for heaven's cross. Everything that's happening, the intensities, the everything right now is asking you to bring it to wisdom. That's how you're going to pass through. That's what the ones in the other realms are doing, whether they're departed, whether they're still here and just helping in the other realms. They're helping, assisting, making sure that there's that balance of wisdom. They're not going to let you try to enter, try to go through this, try to get on that elevator until you've let it come to wisdom. You have to. Otherwise, it'll tear you apart. Everything. No holding back. No macchio. Everything. Some of you have, what you call kind of a pet issues, pet guilt. It's like, no, I got to keep this one. You're being asked now to let it all go to wisdom. You don't have to do a thing, actually, no. Let it go to the soul, and then you will be receiving it back. As this whole time of Heaven's Cross comes, I would say the deepest of all the wounds right now, maybe you don't recognize them, but the deepest of all is still some of that old residual guilt from Atlantis, how it fell, the headbands. Let that go too. I'm going to be coming to you individually, each and every one of you. When I feel that you're holding on, and I'm just going to look you in the eyes, and I'm going to say, wisdom. You're going to know what I mean. Let it go. When you do, you're going to find a lot less of that over-intensity right now. You're going to find a lot less the doubting yourself, thinking that you're crazy. Let's take a deep breath in the beauty of this mirab, a mirab of wisdom. You say it's that cleansing before that big event on the planet, Heaven's Cross. It's an individual thing, but it's going to affect humanity. Such a beauty in literally stepping back and watching how what was perhaps a bad experience can then be transformed into wisdom. Let's take a good deep breath together. We're a little over, just barely over 3 months. It came up much faster. It wasn't until late July of this year that we knew the ratio of consciousness light on the planet was such that it was inevitable that it would now happen, and happen so quickly. It came upon very, very fast. That's why we haven't said much about it. It's a celebration that we had in the other realms, knowing it was not 10 years, 20 years, 30 years away. But now it's barely over 3 months away. Let's take a good deep breath together. we'll be talking more and more about Heaven's Cross. We're kind of pushing everything else aside. Oh, the scurrying that's taking place in the other realms, the readjusting, the recalibrating of everything. Even some of the ascended masters of, you hear them talking around the fireplace and saying, what happened? Well, we knew this was the prophecy. We knew it was going to happen, but not now. And some of them are saying, oh, my group that I'm working with, somebody's channeling me, and gosh, they're still talking about UFOs. And what happened to make this come about so quickly? It caught us. We're supposed to be ascended masters. Caught us by surprise. How are we going to explain this to our groups? That there are no UFOs. If we keep trying to tell them what they want to believe, how do we get them to understand the UFOs are not beings from some other far-off galaxy? They're the humans on Earth, perhaps from the future, or perhaps from Heaven's Cross. And when they say, what happened to cause this? I just sit back and say one word. Benching. With that, dear friends, let's take a deep breath, remembering that all is truly well in all of creation. With that, I am Adamus of Sovereign Domain. Thank you.
So with that, let's take another good deep breath, feeling into this experience, each of us with our own individual experience. Allow it. Feel into this Heaven's Cross and what it means to each of us. Just feel it and be with it, breathe with it. So much coming up so fast. Thank you for being a part of this December shout here in Louisville, Colorado. Thank you, and we'll see you the first Saturday of January. Thank you.